Prepping your skin is super important to look flawless and for your makeup not to look cakey. Skin prep is super, super important. Make sure you massage. Strong. prep your skin. Keep that in mind. Prepping your skin according to your skin. Dry skin, mixed skin, oily skin, whatever the case may be, make sure you're prepping it correctly according to your skin and according to the product you're going to use. I have dry skin, so I like using products that are on the fuller coverage. It means they are on the drier side. So I have dry skin. Drier, you know, oil-free foundations means I gotta be careful because I can look really, really cakey. So I make sure I prep my skin really well. And then this right here is my Bloody Buddy. On myself and my clients, because I am a makeup artist for those that don't know. To give my skin that awake look, just like that. And then I'm gonna go back with my wet sponge, the opposite side. All right, still damp. And I'm going to distribute that just in the inner corner of my face, as you see here. I could have done a little bit more with it.
Just press that down, as you see.
is just fill those bald spots in and kind of shape, give my eyebrows a little bit of a shape, because my eyebrows, as you can see, one is like more of a rounder shape and this one's like an archier shape. So I like to make this one look like this one because this one's my favorite. So you kind of try to do what's best for your skin. Sharpie and you said, don't do that, because that's going to make you look very harsh and it's going to age you. Anyhow, so I'm just going to fill in my bald spots and then shape my eyebrows. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm using MAC Fluid Line Brow Gel Cream. And if you have a spot that's really, really bold, what you can do, I'm going to show you. It's like, be a little heavy-handed. Fill it in really well. It's good to use a brow product, because a brow product, I mean, you can use whatever you want, but a brow product dries a certain way because of the ingredients it contains. So, once it dries, you're able to blend it easier and make it look more natural. So that's why brow products are best for brows. You know, some people use eyeshadows or, you know, just other things. But brow products have a certain ingredient in them that dry a certain way, and it makes it easier for you to make your eyebrows look a little more natural after they dry when you blend them, which is what I like to do. So I went a little heavy-handed on here, and I'm going to show you how I fix that once it's dried. But in the meantime, I'm going to go on to the next eyebrow. Do the same thing here, because I'm really bold on this side, and I like to arch it like this side, so I got You put in your lashes, which is another key to this look, is lashes. You don't have to wear dramatic lashes, you wear the lashes you prefer, but try to wear lashes. Alright, so that part is done. Now I'm gonna let that dry. I'm gonna move on to liner. she could, you know, disguise a little bit or not make it so obvious. And it doesn't necessarily mean you're insecure. It's just that, you know, it just doesn't make you feel good to know it's there. Like, for example, I have really dark circles, or not circles, like bags, and dark circles under my eyes. And it's not because of age, and it's ocean. And it's not because I don't sleep, because I sleep very well. I love my sleep. But it's hereditary. I've had circles under my eyes since I'm little. So, it's just, that's how I am. So, I love a good concealer. Okay, shit. I dropped my lash. Okay. So, I'm moving on to lashes. These lashes are mink lashes. Guys, I threw the box away, so I can't tell you where I got them, but they're full lengthy lashes, but they don't look like umbrellas. I always say umbrellas because some people just don't, just say some people lashes, it's just too much. You gotta use lashes that are dramatic. If you're gonna use dramatic lashes that are according to your eye. I mean, when it comes down to lashes, you gotta be a little careful, because if you have small eyes, you could use dramatic lashes, but they have to be a specific shape and length. Otherwise, it's gonna weigh your eye down, and that's not, you don't want to do that. You want your eyes to look bright and expressive. So, you gotta be careful. Wispy lashes is the best way to go. Not go wrong with wispy lashes. And you can buy them anywhere. Wispy has the perfect shape for any eye. That's why they're so popular. Wispies. They're called Wispies. And any brand sells them. And they're just perfect. They have the perfect amount of fullness. And length. There's demi wispies. Demi wispies are a little shorter. And there's wispies, which are a little longer. So you look and you see what do you think would fit you best. These are the lashes I'm using. And I'm using them with my duo, one of my favorite glues. Change the game 100%. So guys, I'm recording. You know, people say, well, why you gotta look at yourself so much? It's just that my viewfinder is over here, and I'm trying to make sure that I'm in the image properly and things like that. So a lot of times I'm not necessarily looking at myself per se. I'm looking at myself to make sure that I'm in the image, and that my battery's not dead or my SD card hasn't timed out, because it's happened to me where it times out and I have noticed, and I record, and then when I'm about to edit, I'm like, what the hell happened? And it ends up being I kept on recording without recording, if that makes any sense. That's why when you're about to hire a makeup artist, you better know who you're hiring. And don't go always by price, because price can mean a lot of things. I mean, there's people that don't know crap and want to charge you an arm and leg. You know what I'm saying? So be careful. If you're going to pay for something, make sure it's worth it. I don't even know if they sell these anymore, but I've had them for a while. This is in the color, these are called Barely Basin, and they look like this. So take it with a brush, round small brush like this, and I'm going to highlight that area so much. I'm going to concentrate most of the color and the pigment there. And then when I'm done, sometimes it's good if you wet the brush, but I like to do that afterwards, like as a last step. My little secrets. So, alright, just like that. So once I'm done, I'm gonna take off the excess, and then I'm gonna brush what I have left on the top inside. Done. My face is now complete. Guys, this completes this tutorial. I know a lot of you request my tutorials, but like I've said before, I want to do a little bit of everything on my channel, so this is my favorite things to do.